You cannot be serious. Goblins working with rookwood makes no sense.
It is rather unorthodox, to say the least.
Unorthodox? It's inconceivable. It's... Ah, Fig. You have a visitor. I'll see what I can find out.
Sir, I was able to search the restricted section while you were with Professor Black. It was a book we were after.
What? That's... Wait. You accessed the restricted section? But how? Thinking on it, perhaps it's best you spare me the details.
Fair enough. In fact, the book was below the restricted section as it appeared on the map.
I want to hear everything. First, let's have a look. Oh dear. Some of these pages seem to be missing. It appears someone has got to the book before us. Still, I will need time to study what remains. Perhaps we can still salvage something useful, though it may take some time. I wonder why it was here, below Hogwarts.
I think I know, sir. I saw two more memories where I found the book.
Another pensive. Godric's heart.
The man we saw before, Percival Rackham, was a professor here. The first memory showed him and three other professors using ancient magic to restore a hamlet from a drought.
Miriam was right. And the second memory?
They were talking to a student who started as a fifth year, like I did. She could see traces of magic too.
Why those memories? Perhaps this book will explain. Now I'll have to take it with me to London. The headmaster has insisted that I speak directly to the minister about George's death.
What will you tell them about Mr. Osric's death?
I don't know how much I dare say. George tried to convince the ministry about Ranrock, but to no avail. My instinct is to follow the path we are on for the moment and keep the details to ourselves until we know more.
I understand. I'll see what I can learn about the missing pages while you're gone.
Good. Don't neglect your studies. Your wand work is improving by the day. But you'll want to pay attention in herbology and potions. There's more to magic than spellcasting.
Plenty to keep me occupied while you're gone.
You've done exceptionally well. I look forward to seeing all that you've accomplished when I return. Oh, and don't neglect your friends. You may be surprised by how much you can learn from them as well.
Revelio.
It's time to prove your dueling mettle and see if we've a new school champion. Meet me at the usual place for the final round of crossed wands. Also, the training dummy is still available.
Meet me in Lower Hogsfield as soon as possible. I would like to talk to you about Rookwood and Harlow, and it might be best to do so outside of the castle.
Thank you.
Professor Fig and Weasley have asked that I teach you an additional defensive spell. Please complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
Can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu.
Revelio. Lumos.
I could want the greenhouse of flowers.
Often.
Is she growing pungent onion again?
Good morning, Professor Garlic.
How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear.
Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie.
Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. How thrilling it is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bulb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio! Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears. Now, everyone, grip their mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug.
Quickly! Place your mandrake in the new pot and pack down the soil!
envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Reparo! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone. Now for our next task, we'll be planting Dittany at our potting tables. You can all get started. I need to have a brief word with our new...
I wonder if hippogriffs like knot grass.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
Actually, I enjoyed it. I couldn't help but catch your enthusiasm.
How kind of you. It seems you're already taking to herbology like a mandrake to fresh soil. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting Dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle arrangement. Niffler's Fancy or Roses?
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganweld potion, as you all should know from Professor Sharp's class. Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage. You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron. The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear, and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice to meet you. I'm Leander. I'll be showing you the Chinese chomping cabbages. Up these stairs will take us there. But your lead. Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian! And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant.
Oh.
Here we are. Home of the Chinese chomping cabbage. Go on, grab a few of those cabbages. Just mind your fingers. I almost lost a... Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest. Look at that. They'll chomp on anything they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. It did save her the denoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that just have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
Trust me, Leander. I was imagining it the entire time.
You were? I mean, of course, you're not someone to be trifled with. I see that. Dogweed and Deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
Revelio.
Helpful reminder as to why we should always wear our dragonhide gloves. I shall end our lesson here. Terribly sorry, Mr. Clopton.
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Hope those mandrakes are really relishing their new pots. Only cost me my damned hearing.
Revelio.
Never a dull moment when I go.
Shouldn't there be Aurora or someone from the Ministry guarding the school after the incident in Hogsmeade?
Professor Black...
More than he's letting on about the Goblin Rebellion.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wigan Weld potion. Mr. Takar, can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wigan Weld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wigan Weld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous. I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain and will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing, and we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the rumors of a goblin.
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
Yes, but why does that matter to you?
Brilliant! And it matters because you can be a part of something truly creative. I'm Gareth, by the way. Gareth Weasley. Bit of a prodigy with potions, if I do say so myself.
Pleasure to meet you. Wait, are you related to Professor Weasley?
She's my aunt. Keeps too close an eye on me for comfort. Ugh. But she can't be everywhere. Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single fooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I'll get you the fooper feather, as long as you're certain Sharp won't miss it.
I assure you he won't. Fooper feathers aren't that valuable. Wait until you see what I'm brewing. Hurry back to me when you have the feather.
Remember,
precision is key when brewing potions.
Potion stations organized and free of clutter.
Here's the fwopper feather you wanted.
Brilliant! Thank you! This is going to take a moment to brew. You should get back to brewing your Edurus potion, and I'll tell you when this concoction's finished.
Should you chop the dittany or crush it? wrong answer could result in the unfortunate loss of your eyebrows.
And now we add the mallow sweet, and that's odd. What's happening? Wait, it's not supposed to. Ah!
Get it! Not again. Oh!
Dragon dung! What happened?
Well done, Gareth.
What now, Mr. Weasley?
Sorry, Professor.
That'll be points from Gryffindor. Again, Mr. Weasley did not do this on his own. His accomplice will answer to me as well.
I brewed an Adura's potion as you asked, Professor.
I'm surprised you had the time. You seemed rather busy helping Mr. Weasley brew chaos.
I'm sorry, Professor. I was merely trying to help a friend.
Taking responsibility for one's actions does go a long way with me. I shall assume that you've learnt a lesson. As for the work you did today at your own cauldron, I will say you've done well. I confess I was skeptical given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all. I think each of us has had enough excitement for one day. Class is dismissed.
Greetings. Ugh, my robes are going to reek from Gareth's inspiration.
Last time I have a potion idea.
Good on you for stopping that troll. When you really think about it.
Revelio.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
I should investigate.
It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Natty. How are you? I hope you've recovered from our rather eventful trip to Hogsmeade.
I am well, but I have been worried about you, my friend. With Ranrock and Rookwood and Harlow after you?
I'm all right at the moment.
We did not speak about it at the time, but I am hoping now you might tell me why they were looking for you.
I've never met Rookwood or Harlow. Perhaps they mistook me for another student.
A bit odd. The two of them pursuing a Hogwarts student so intently. But whatever the reason, you were clearly in danger. For now, it is safe to say that Rookwood and Harlow are a threat to both of us, to all of us. Which is why I wanted to speak to you. I realized something that day in Hogsmeade. You displayed such courage fighting that troll. And Serona wasn't intimidated one bit by Rookwood and Harlow. Both of you have inspired me to take a stand of my own.
What sort of stand?
Men like Rookwood and Harlow are the reason my mother and I left Matibililand. I am not going to sit by and watch them destroy my new home.
Good. Rookwood and Harlow are a dangerous pair. And the fact that they're working with Ranrock, well...
All the more reason they must be stopped. Rumor has it that Theophilus Harlow runs Rookwood's day-to-day operations. Taking him down would cripple Rookwood's entire enterprise.
That may be true, but shouldn't Officer Singer handle someone like Harlow?
I spoke with her. She was polite, but perhaps understandably would not discuss details with a student. I overheard some of Rookwood's lot talking about a massive poaching operation that Harlow is planning. I was thinking that we could investigate a bit, try to get the evidence that Officer Singer needs.
All right, but how?
I am going to watch and listen, find out precisely what Harlow is up to. I shall reach out when I know more. In the meantime, remember, I am here if you need me.
Thank you, Natty.
Be on your guard.
I beg your pardon! How dare you threaten me!
What's going on here?
They must have come this way! Think!
I've no idea who it is you think I might have seen. I've been busy with my research. I do not have time to...
Victor Rookwood don't give a doxy's nip about your time.
Oi! Speak of the devil! Mr. Rookwood would like a word with you.
A student! You can't be
Enough out of you.
Leave her alone.
Stupefy!
You there! I see!
I'll watch the light go out of your eyes. Just happened. I've never been accosted in such a manner, and so close to Hogwarts.
Are you all right?
I am, thanks in no small part to your excellent defensive skills. Care to tell me why two Ashwinders were ready to dispatch me to get to you?
Ashwinders?
Victor Rookwood's thieves and extortionists, his little cronies. They seemed quite keen on you.
It's a long story, but... thank you for your help.
Well, you've avoided them for the moment. Priya warned me things were getting dangerous. Best get moving on my research before they return.
You mentioned someone named Priya.
Yes, my wife. She's the one who piqued my interest in Merlin, gave me a book when we were students at Hogwarts. Typical hard-working Hufflepuff, brilliant potioner, has her own shop in Nocturne Alley. She's a travelling vendor. Here's what's going on in the Highlands before I do.
You're a researcher?
Nora Treadwell at your service. Historian and archaeologist specialising in Merlin's work and life.
I thought that Merlin and the tales about King Arthur's court were a myth.
Mere myth? You're lucky Sir Cadogan didn't hear you. Chatters on endlessly about his connection to Merlin from his portrait at Hogwarts. Merlin attended Hogwarts, you know, and I'm studying some curious fixtures he left here centuries ago.
Fixtures?
These vine-covered pillars, dozens of them all around the area. I've taken to calling them the Trials of Merlin.
I believe he created them as a diversion for his fellow Slytherins. He was terribly fond of puzzles and enigmas.
I can see why you're so interested in Merlin. I'd be keen to know more about the trials.
Well then, I'll let you in on a little secret. No one has yet managed to figure out how they work. But I believe I have just unlocked a crucial clue. I suspect that Mallow Sweet is an important component in getting the trials to work.
Mallow Sweet?
Versatile herb. Merlin repeatedly mentioned it in his writings. I had just arrived to test my theory when I was so rudely interrupted. You see, each swirl in Merlin's writing has a symbol in the center. That started me thinking, what if...
The Mallow Sweet is meant to be placed at the center of the symbols.
Precisely. Would you care to do the honors? We can see what comes of our little hypothesis. I brought a trunk chock full of Mallow Sweet with me. It's just over there by my tent.
This trunk?
Yes, take plenty, even if you already have some.
I have the Mallow Sweet.
Lovely. Now, notice the vines on these pillars here, as well as a stone swirl on the ground. Each trial has these features. Place the Mallow Sweet on the swirl, and we'll see what happens. Did you see that? The vines disappeared.
What should I do now?
This is uncharted territory. I am curious about these pyres. Conjuring fire might work. These are pyres, after all.
Incendio!
The flames make the pyre sink.
Curious. The pyres are back where they started. Hardly believe it.
Revelio.
I take it we can call that a success?
We can indeed. However, I now have even more questions. How does it work? I must review my notes. I may have missed something.
Are all of the trials like this one?
Oh, not precisely. Well, I think each has those telltale vines and the swirl on the ground. You should feel free to solve them as you come across them. I believe I have what I need to continue my research. My guess is that each will also require Mallow Sweet, which you can find in Hogsmeade should you need more. I really must be off. Such a pleasure to meet you. And do be careful out here. Now, I've got what I needed. I shall return to the safety of my notes and books.
Greetings, young Slytherin. Scrope knows about the old book you found for Professor Fig. Scrope can help you. And you can help Scrope. Get to the courtyard past the pendulum. If you don't know it, you'll see it easy enough. And don't tell anyone what you're up to. Especially Professor Black.